Hi guys, so we're just going to show you how to copy a community page in Beaver Builder. We're going to use the Stone Creek Ocala page as an example. And this is really just going to be a basic demonstration. So you can start by just launching Beaver Builder. When you click on the page content, it should pull up a lot of code. We're basically just going to show you how to remake this in Beaver Builder, because as you can see, it's really not friendly to the visual page editor, and that's why it's pulling up that weird code instead of something that looks nice like the modules that we're going to show you next. You can decide how many columns you want in the rows section there and continue dragging each row individually and decide how you want to change columns as you go. We can also change them into full width to make sure it spans the full width of the page. You can change all different kinds of text colors individually here, but then there's also the option that we can show you to customize the colors all at once using like kind of a theme customizer instead. You can see here we went ahead and changed the photo and this hero image text that's over it there. We're really just inspecting the original page on the old site and taking any of that information over to the new site so that we can get those styles copied over as quickly as possible. Beaver Builder also makes it really easy to just duplicate things in order to not have to continuously make the same style changes over and over again. So as you can see, that's what we did with that heading there. You can really just go down the list here, copying all of these margins, font styles, colors, and everything else that's on the page already. Once you start working with Beaver Builder, it just becomes really easy to work with in general. So it's really not a big deal when you have to go in and make these edits, because you can just click on the section that you need to change, and it kind of just pulls up all of these settings for you. You don't have to know too much about where to go or where to find it. Next, we've added in the click to call button, and you can always just drag the correct module that you're trying to work with down there. There's usually something for everything. There's buttons, there's content sliders, there's photos, text editors, video editors, pretty much everything that you could embed or insert into a page. We have a module for it in there. My favorite aspect of Beaver Builder is how easy it really makes it to just play around with all the different options and styles, and oftentimes you'll even end up with something that looks better than what you had before. There's even a bunch of built-in icons for other types of buttons, like the View All Homes for Sale. That's already input into the theme files there, so it makes it even easier to just go ahead and add those. Now that we've done some of the easy edits, let's go ahead and get this map over on the new site. So first thing we need to do is we need to pull up the Google Maps link so that we have the exact address where we want and click that share button. From there, you should see another tab to embed a map. That's what you're going to want to click and then copy that HTML code. You're going to want to paste that over into a custom HTML embed section. And here we're going to make sure it's also in the right side column so that again we're copying that page styling. And we'll continue to show you how to add each little individual point to this page so that you are left with a perfect copy of the same community page that you had on the original site. Keep in mind, I've also sped everything up to twice the speed, so if you can't go this fast, don't worry about it. You can always slow it down to half the speed to see exactly what's going on. we'll finish up by doing the CSS for these lists, and then in the next video, we'll show you how the saved link setup works in IDX Broker.